this session, let us learn how to get user input or values from the command line. What is the meaning of getting values from the command line? Basically, when you run an application, you know how to compile it. You use Java C. While running the application, you use the interpreter Java space the class name. When you are giving the class name, together with that, if you want to provide input, you can give the values. What will be the type of values, the data type of the values? Let us analyze that first. If you see, I have got an array over here, string args. So this is an array. Now, I am coming to the example. I am giving Java C space cmd demo dot Java. This is the compilation part. What is the next step? To run it, I have to specify Java space cmd demo. Now, together with that, I want to give the values. So, what type of value should I give? I have to give the values which is of type string. This is the array which is getting invoked by reading the values that you are giving in the command line. Whatever you are going to give over here is nothing but the array which is shown in public static void main. Assume I am giving A space B space C. A, B, C. This is the array value. And the size of the array is 3. And what is the name of the array? Args. What data type it is? String. So, A, B, C represent the string array. Now, what if I give 1, 2, 3, 4? What is the size of the array? The size of the array is 4. And what are the values? 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the data type? Again, it is string only. And what is the name of the array? Args. So, whatever is coming inside will be double quotes 1, double quotes 2, double quotes 3, like this. Okay. Now, how to get the values? Once when you are running the application, you are feeding in the values. How to get the values inside public static void main? And what is the name of this array? Args. So, using args of 0, args of 1, args of 2, I can get the values. In the first case, args of 0, A. Args of 1, B. Args of 2 is C. Can I get args of 3? If I try to get args of 3 doesn't exist because the array size itself is 3 only. So, it will throw array index out of bounds exception. Okay. Now, let me come to the second one. It is having value 1, 2, 3, 4. And when I give args of 1, what is the type? It is of type string. Args of 2, type string. So, whatever you are getting inside will be of type string only. If you want to convert, you need to use certain methods to convert from string to int, or string to double, or string to long. Okay, let us try this out in Eclipse, this simple example. I am having my public static void main. Inside this only I am going to get the values. I assume that while running the application, you are going to give 3 values. So, I am going to get args of 0, args of 1 and args of 2. To start with, let me assume that I am getting name of the person, city of the person and the department of that particular person. So, here let me write string name equal to args of 0, city and department. City and department is args of 1 and args of 2. Now, what is the size of the array? The size of the array is 3. When you are going to feed in values through the command line, the array size should be either 3 or more than that. If it is less than 3, then it will throw array index out of bound exception. Now, let me also print all these. So, let me go and type syso name plus slash t, tab space plus city plus slash t, again a tab space plus department. Okay, I am saving this. Now, I will explain you how to add the command line values. Before that, let me try running it directly. How to run? Control F11. You are getting an exception, array index out of bound exception in which line? Line number 6. Line number 6 is args of 0. You have not given values for this args array. So, it is giving you an exception. How to give the values? Let me show it to you. Select the file, right click, run as, run configuration. Not as Java application, run configuration. You are going to do some configuration to run your application. So, here, what is the console name, configuration name? CMD demo. Project name, demo project. What is the fully qualified class name? com.training.arrays.cmd demo. Come to the next tab. Here, arguments. This is the second tab, arguments. In the program arguments, select variables. In the search box, type yes. Everything related to yes will appear. Select string prompt. Click OK. Click apply. Apply means it is fixed. If you don't apply, every time you need to do that. So click apply. You can see that dollar curly brace string prompt. It means that this is ready to accept the values whatever you are going to give now. When you click run, a new window will open. It is expecting you to give the values. So what are the values you have to give? You have to give three values. Name, city and department. Let me give it Ram, Bangalore, admin. Okay, click OK. You can see the output. Okay, I have not given backslash. I have given forward slash. So that is the error. Save it. Let me run it. Ram, Bangalore and admin. If you want to print this in a new line, how you can give? Slash N. Control F11. Talking for the name Ram, Bangalore and admin. Click OK. Ram, Bangalore, admin is printed in the next line. Okay. Now this is very simple. We'll go in for still more complicated things. I will run it, but while giving the value, I will not give three values. I'm just going to give two values. What will happen? You are not giving the size of the array as 3. You are making the size of the array as 2. So when you are trying to get args of 2, it will give you an exception. Now let me run it. Exception in thread main. Array index outer bound exception in line number 8. So this exception is thrown in this particular line. Okay. What will happen if I am going to give more than 3 values? Admin space hello. Click OK. The size of the array is 4. But what I want is only 3 values. So in that case it will not throw an exception. Understand this. If your array size is greater than what actually you are expecting over here, your application will work fine. If the array size is less than what you are feeding in there, then in that case, or what you are expecting over here, in that case, it will throw an exception. Now, whatever we have got till now is only of type string. What if I want an integer value? Like say, I want to get the age and salary. So let me get the age and salary. So here I am going to specify age. Args of 3 and the next one is salary. Salary is args of 4. And now I will comment city and department now. So here it has to be 1 and 2. We'll have this as 1 and 2. And now it is name, age. Name and age I will print. Let me complete this. Okay. Have a look into this program. I'm trying to get name, age, salary and bonus. You know that age, salary, bonus, they are of different data types. But whatever you are feeding in will be coming inside as a string only. As a developer, you have to convert it in whichever format you want. I am trying to print name, age, salary and bonus. I am trying to add. What will happen? The both of them are strings, so it will concatenate. Here it is not a plus operator. It is a concatenator. Let us check the output. Control S, Control F11. I have to give 4 values. So here, Ram, age 23, then salary 1000 and this one 900. Click OK. See the output. Ram and 23 is printed properly. When you are trying to add, it is just concatenating. Why? The reason is it is taken in as a string. Now what you have to do is explicitly you need to convert it. How to convert? For conversion, there are methods available. If you want to convert a string, a double quote 100, into an integer, the method is parsint, that is parsxxx. If you want to convert a string into double, it is parsdouble. If you want to convert a float to a string to float, it is parsfloat or parslong. So now what we will do is we will use that method. So let me start with age. Age is of type integer, so I have to go in for parsint. See the method. The method is parsint of args of 1. What type of method it is or from where it is coming? This method is from a wrapper class integer. It is from java.lang package. You know that whenever there is a method, it has to be called only using object. in this case, you don't need any object. Directly, you can call it using the class name. It is a static method. It is a class method. So, I can write integer dot parseInt. You can see the method description given over here. Integer dot parseInt string. What is the return type? The return type is int. If I use double dot parse double, the return type is double. If I am using float dot parse float, the return type is float. Okay. So here I have used integer. See, I is capital, meaning to say that this is called as a wrapper class. This is a class which is wrapped around the int primitive data type. We will talk about this later. As of now, just understand integer is a class. It is from java.lang package. If you want to convert a string into int primitive data type, you have to use this class. Okay. Why it's giving an error? Because the return type is of return is int. Next, for salary, let me use double. Double salary equal to double dot parse double. See, the method has come automatically. Parse double of args of 2. And for bonus, let me use float. Bonus is equal to float dot parse float of args of 3. Understand, whatever you are giving in the array in command line, it will come inside as a string only. So 1000.5, that is double quotes 1000.5, 12.6, double quotes 12.6, 10, double quotes 10. Here, after coming inside, you are converting it. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Now let us save this and run it. Now I will give proper values, name, age, salary. I have to give it as a double. So let me explicitly add a decimal value. I will give EC values for me too. So 4 values I have given. Click OK. Yeah. 900 plus 100. So 1000 point, it is just giving it in the form of a double. So salary plus bonus, it is printed. So what we have done? We are trying to retrieve the values from the command line array. The command line array is of type string. So you need to convert it. Now this is all fine. What will happen if I try to give less number of values? This you know already. We have seen it. It is going to throw array index out of bound exception. Okay, well and good. What will happen if I try to give string instead of numbers? So Ram, Tom, Jack, J. So my array size is 4. I have to give 4 values. That I am giving it properly. But once when it is going in, you are trying to convert it. In case of the first value, args of 0, Ram is taken in as such. In case of the second value, you are trying to convert it into integer. What will happen if you try to convert a real integer, a real string into an integer? What is the meaning of a real string? That is, if you are having Ram, double quotes Ram, that is a string. You cannot convert it into int. Double quotes 100 can be converted into int. Double quotes Priya cannot be converted into double. Double quotes 1000.5 can be converted into double. So, if you are trying to convert a string into a primitive data type, in that case, you will get number format exception. You can see that number format exception for input string Tom. In which line? See, it is showing the line number also. CMD demo, line number 9. Okay, so the error is happening in this particular line. So, to wrap up, we are trying to get values from the command line and assign it to this particular args array. And depending upon our requirement, we are converting it. If you want as integer or double or use it as string directly, that also can be done. So this is all about getting the values from the command line. Thank you.